Okay, so here we are. So what I'd like to do this morning is go over the sort of intro lecture that we didn't get to last night, just to kind of put forward some ideas for you to be thinking about in terms of the differences and similarities in the two systems that we are exploring here today. I love milkweed. Milkweed is one of my favorite plants, and when I came here and found all the milkweed opening, I was just so excited. And we don't have it. As much as I love it, it doesn't grow in my garden. And I think it's too foggy in San Francisco. So let's talk about these two systems of knowledge that we're here to explore. And to find the places where they meet and find the places where they might diverge in their way of working. And so I'd like to define both of them. And again, I think there's many ways to describe both, and I'm offering you one set of definitions. And I'm sure that there's more similarities that can be found and discovered between them, and more differences that can be found between them. But I think that, you know, this is a starting point, and I'm very aware that we have, you know, a lot of material to cover, so it might be a little bit abbreviated in terms of the introduction. But please feel free to always ask questions and offer thoughts, because it's important to have your questions answered, and these are both very, very broad subjects. So, as I say, I may not be able to cover everything. So I'm going to start just with a general, you know, a general definition. It's not the definition of either one of them. But the shamanic tradition, or the shamanic traditions, are very, very ancient traditions that have arisen in almost all cultures that have ever been on the planet. Ours is one of the few that does not have shamanism as its primary spiritual center for the culture. And one of the interesting things about shamanic practice, although you have practices arising in Mongolia, in Africa, Australia, North and South America, that might look a little bit different on the outside because of the cultural setting and the difference in the natural setting where they are, the practices are quite similar. And it's important to note this, because when you have this kind of a flowering of knowledge that has to do with healing, that has to do with problem solving, that has to do with education, that has to do with ritual creation, that has to do with divination, that has to do with the guiding of the souls of the dead and the care of the dead. When you have practices that are so similar, addressing these similar issues that all shamans address in the cultures, in traditional settings that they serve, you have to ask, what is the common thread? Like, where the common root? Where, how is this happening? And the answer to that question is because all of these traditions have the same teacher. And that teacher is the earth. So shamanic traditions are designed to access this unseen power of the earth. And the way that you find, there are several methods that you find that, again, are very similar in many cultures where shamanism has existed for accessing this wisdom and receiving these teachings. And one of the methods is the shamanic journey. And that's what we're going to be focusing on. And I'll be giving you a little bit more of a lecture and information about the journey itself in just a little bit. So again, when you know the shamans in the cultures where they arise or where they work are the doctors, the ministers, the teachers, the problem solvers. They are the ones who create the rituals that bind the cultural members together, and they are the ones that help care for the dead. And in some cultures, you have one person doing all of these processes, and in other cultures, you might have multiple shamans that are operating within the culture to offer their assistance. So the essential aspect of shamanic practice in the way that it relates to siddhic practice is there is this effort to go beyond the physical forms that surround us and to understand what are the more subtle aspects of reality and how are they affecting our material experience. And in shamanic cultures, the shaman is the one who's in charge of bringing that the power that is in this unseen world into the affairs of those who are that the shaman serves. Now, in terms of siddhic practice, now siddhas, I actually think that